Sup fuckers, alright, welcome to the channel. It's my first video I'm actually recording since my rib incident. I'm all healed up. Yay, it's been a month, it's awesome. But anyway, we're here with the top five favorite assassins from Assassin's Creed. Now I'm gonna say my fifth, then he's gonna say his fifth, so on and so forth, okay? But I'm gonna say this. My top five is not gonna have Ezio.
Really?
Do you know why? Because Ezio had three games.
You could say which game.
But that's what I'm saying. All of the ones that I have in my top five have one game for them. Okay? So they're singular games. Now, everyone loves Ezio, because if they didn't love him, there wouldn't be three games of the fucker.
True.
Okay? So that's why I'm excluding Ezio, because everyone likes Ezio. So, I mean, obviously, if I put Ezio as, like, number three, everybody's going to be like, go fucking figure. Everybody likes Ezio. But yeah, that's not why, you know, that's why we're not putting, I'm not putting Ezio in mine. So, Joey.
Aaron's in the corner.
Aaron's in the corner, right here in the little thing. You're not going to see him. Fuck it. So, my number five is Altair. And the reason is because he's the first one, technically the first one with the video game series, okay? So, the reason I say Altair is because he was all hot shit, got brought down to nothing, and then he had to work his way back up to the top to rethink his decisions and to mature once again. Because growing up as an orphan to being an assassin, you get kind of big-headed, and then they're like, no, fuck you. And then he had to relearn the ways of the assassin. He had to reteach himself how to be a noble person and, like, to help the weak.
True.
That's why I like it, because his whole game was a learning lesson. Because he went from nothing, became something, got like full of himself, like, hey, I'm hot shit. Then reality check, and then he had to learn it all over again. So he had to be like, wow, I'm not as big as what I thought I was. And he had to learn that, hey, I was a piece of shit. Now I'm better. I like Altair, because Assassin's Creed 1 was like a shot in the dark, pretty much. Like, it was supposed to be the next Prince of Persia. But they went so far in the left field that they just was like, fuck it, we're going to just change it to Assassin's Creed. And they made it its own thing. So I'll tell you number five.
Adewale.
Adewale?
Adewale. Yeah, he didn't have the biggest game, but he was a big influence in Assassin's Creed 4. He'd always fought for what he believed in. He's against slavery. He's like, fuck this shit. Fuck you guys. Fuck them.
I ain't about this shit.
Yeah.
All right, good, good. I was gonna put Adewale in there, but I didn't.
I did.
Because I didn't play Freedom Cry. I have it. It's on PC. I don't got it on PlayStation.
Yeah. So whenever we got it on PS4.
So
on PS3 as well.
Yeah, I'm gonna play it on PlayStation, or I'm gonna play it on PC instead of PlayStation. So my number four is Bayek of Siwa.
No, I completely forgot about Bayek, to be honest.
The reason
he's not gonna be on my list for right now.
I've put how many hours into Assassin's Creed Origin?
53.
53 hours, haven't even beat the story mode, played all the side quests, and just from what I've played of story mode and all the side quests, he is the definition of a warrior.
Oh yeah, definitely.
All right. Now, I can say that we can all agree, whoever has played Origins, that, you know, Bayek won my heart as soon as he did this.
I just wait in the shadows, and I will kill you all! Everyone who sniffed the air that day in Siwa!
But yeah, that's what won me on Bayek. He's a fucking badass when he needs to, but he's also so kind and so innocent to the, like, to the people in need and to children. You have not met a motherfucker so nice to the kids. Like, he could just fucking kill a guy, and like 5 seconds later, hi, how are you doing today? I'm going to shoot an arrow in the sun one day. Haha, good for you. He's so fucking nice.
Yeah, that's what you call, like, psycho killers?
I'm just saying, like, he's so fucking nice.
Yeah, I completely forgot about him.
Like, Bayek is a true warrior. He believes in family morals. Like,
yeah, I mean, he's a protector, and that's what he has to be.
Exactly.
For all of Egypt. It's not just, you know, where he's from, Siwa, it's everybody.
He thinks of everyone as family. Like, he wants everybody to live how they want to live, not be endangered, not be hurt, not anything. So that's what really made me like Bayek from the beginning. Plus, the scene got it for me. The beginning got it for me. All right, but that's my number four.
I'm going to go with Ezio. And not just from, like, I enjoy all the games with Ezio, but from Revelations, which I think was the worst one out of the three what people considered.
Critics.
You know, but he's old, well, not old, but older, wise, you know, coming to where he's trying to figure out what he wants to do in the rest of his life at the end, but he teaches people along the way. And always gunning for the old guys, like Liam Neeson. Keep it going, man.
Sean Connery.
Yeah.
But, all right, my number three, it's a tie. The Fry Twins.
Oh.
But, more importantly, Evie Fry.
I knew you were going to say that.
Evie Fry. Evie is fucking adorable. That's what won my heart. I love Evie. Evie is great. The reason, not so much Jacob. I do love Jacob, but Jacob plays like how I like to play. Jacob is the guy that's just like, I'm going to fucking mess you up and fucking curb stomp you and make you wish you were dead. Then I'm not going to do it until you ask me to do it.
Yeah, he's real gung-ho.
He is. He does it without thinking. And Evie, she thinks way ahead of her schedule. She's like, we got to do this, then that properly, the assassin way. And
yeah, Jacob's like, fuck that.
Yeah, Jacob's like, I am going to be the leader of the Blighters or whatever the fuck. Yeah, the rooks. Yeah, that's where they were. Yeah. We're going to be the leader of the rooks, and we're going to take over England. And we're like, no, you're an assassin, you stupid piece of shit. Listen to Evie. Go in the corner.
You have a ladybug on your screen. That was the ladybug Aaron was feeling in his hair.
It's fine, dude. I have ladybugs. This long story. There's ladybugs every time that it goes from fall to winter. There's ladybugs. It's fine. But no, Evie Fry, definitely, because she is pretty much the embodiment of an assassin. Like, she's trying to keep it traditional, like, by the books, how to do it properly, stay in the shadows, while Jacob's like, what's up, bitch? What up? What it do?
I like playing against him better, though.
I know, but Evie's my number three. I mean, I like Jacob, but it's a tie, but Evie wins.
Edward's my number three. Because what a lot of people, I think, got mad about Black Flag was, like, oh, he's supposed to be an assassin. Well, he's a pirate first. That's what you gotta remember. He's just doing what he thinks. He's going after the booty. Figuratively and literally. But he learns along the way. He learns at the end, you know, his path needs to lead to him being an assassin and doing what's morally right for him instead of just looting and taking and
raping and pillaging.
Yeah, exactly. And he's like, you know what? I'm not about this lifestyle no more. I might go bang a few hoes on the side, but hey, this is what we're gonna do. And in the end, the assassins are like, yeah, you need to be this motherfucker.
Yep. My number two, Connor Kenway. And the reason is because for the first 3 months of playing the fucking game, I was hunting. I didn't do a damn thing.
He didn't. I beat the game. I text Alex, hey, have you beat this? No, I'm hunting. No. You've been hunting for 4 years now. Stop it.
Dude, you don't know how much joy I get from planting a trip mine in the woods and a fucking gazelle just going,
you mean a deer.
Whatever. I don't even care. Just like a deer exploding up in the air or you air assassinating a bear is the best feeling in the world.
I remember you showed me the frozen deer and you're like, it's 150 meters from this point. And you took me right there to it. And I'm like, how did you find this?
Yeah, there was a frozen deer right here on the map, and I was just like, you gotta go here, and you gotta go up here, and it's right here. And then Joey goes, how the fuck did you know that was there?
Like, I 100% of that game and got every single trinket and everything, and I didn't even find it.
Yeah. Now, the real reason I say Connor is because Connor is a nobleman. Like Bayek, strong to his heritage. Like, he's very noble, he wants to be upfront, truthful, loyal. He wants you to be loyal to him. He takes your word. And if you betray his trust, it's pretty much done. You're dead. I mean, he has the saddest backstory other than Bayek. He has the saddest fucking story out of all of them. All he wants to gain is the respect of his father, which he never gets. Which, I mean, I have the same situation going on, but fuck that. We're not getting into that. But, like, I can relate to Connor a whole lot because He's a noble Native American just living in a corrupted world. It's pretty much what it is. He just wants it to be peace and tranquil, pretty much like Zenyatta. But, yeah, number two, Connor.
Say Patrick Cormac.
See, I didn't play that.
Because even though he ends up not being an assassin in the end, and he ends up being a Templar, which everybody knows, you know, look at the name, Rogue. But no matter what, he fought for what he believed in, whether being an assassin or Templar. He went and done what he thought was the right thing to do, and to help save humanity, whether you want to look at it from this standpoint or the other. I think that's all the reason that Ubisoft made Rogue was, it's like, okay, if you're the type of person that thinks, well, assassins aren't always right, well, here's a game for you. You can have both sides of the story. It's your choice. But I like him because of his character and the fact that he goes after what he believes is right.
Okay. Now, my number one is Edward Kenway. And pretty much the same reason is Edward is a pirate first, learning to be an assassin. And I think that's what the series needed, was everyone was to the books, all, you know, from Altair to Ezio, all three of Ezio's games, it was by the books. If you do one thing wrong, it's a desynchronized or some stupid shit, and then this
optional
objectives here. Now, that was the best fucking thing ever. It's like, you don't have to do everything by the book. You have four pistols, two swords, and an entire array of bombs, sleeping darts, and whatever. Have fun. That's it. And
You do you, boo-boo.
I love saying that. But it was just fun. Going in there, beating the shit out of everybody. I have all the sea shanties on my fucking Spotify. Like, I listen to those on the way to work. Like, I know all the words to all of them now. The fights, like the ship fights, were the best thing that they could have done. But now they're doing a separate game where it's Assassin's Creed boat battles, but that's the entire subject matter, and it's called Black Sails or something. Skull and Bones.
Yeah,
that's what it is. Skull and Bones.
Bones. Yeah, I think about getting that as well. I don't know if I'll pay full price for it, but I really enjoyed the ship battles in 4, a little bit in 3, and then in Rogue as well.
But with Edward, he goes in there. He thinks he has nothing in life. He thinks that he doesn't matter. Pretty much. Like, when you get down to the nitty-gritty when it comes to Edward, he's like, the love of my life is gone. I have no, like, part in the world, yada, yada. He's just going to strictly be a pirate, and that's all he's ever going to be. When they gave him the opportunity to be an assassin, to be something better, that's what he goes for. He's like, maybe I can mature myself and be better than what I believe I am. And then he raises a family. Granted, his son kills him, but still.
Yeah, shit happens.
Shit happens when you party naked.
Only two party.
It is to party naked.
So therefore,
now something's gonna happen.
Which brings me to the next point.
Don't smoke crack.
Yeah.
And then your number one, sir?
Is Connor Kenway. Some of my ancestors, or heritage, as you like to say, is Native American. Cherokee, to be specific. Now, I don't think Connor's Cherokee. I think he's something, you know, from a different tribe. But he's my favorite because of his will to do the right thing until his dying breath. When I first played Assassin's Creed, when I first heard about Assassin's Creed 3 coming out, this motherfucker told me it's coming out. I didn't think I was going to like it because of where I enjoyed playing as Ezio so much. I'm like, why don't they make another game of Ezio? Like Alex said, everybody loves Ezio. And so I didn't think I was going to enjoy it as much as I did. And when I started playing it, and the hunting and the crafting and just being able to go through the woods and then into...
And you can also make your own entire village that makes timber and everything for you to where you didn't have to do it.
And then going into the cities and stuff and the missions and was incredible. The fighting style in 3, 4, and Rogue, I absolutely enjoyed. I wish every time they make another Assassin's Creed, bring that back or have the option to bring it back. But one thing that really sold me on Connor was at one of the last missions whenever he's fighting Charles Lee and he's wounded. He's like, why do you fight? Because no one else will. That right there, his will to do the right thing until he would die for his people and others that are morally good.
And that's what I'm saying. He's like a noble person. Yeah. Like he knows what's right. He knows what's wrong. He knows what should be done and what shouldn't be done.
Until he dies, he's doing the right thing, the best of his ability to do the right thing or what he would think is the right thing. Yeah. And that's why I like Connor.
Now, those are our top five. Take it or leave it. If you agree, cool. If you don't, cool. Don't care. We all have opinions. They're like assholes. So, so I'm going to say this. That the honorable, if I can talk properly, the honorable mentions that I have would be Evelyn, because I didn't get to play that game. The chick, and the PSP. Is that her name? Evelyn?
The chick and the PSP.
The PSP game.
Oh, Evelyn.
Yeah, Evelyn.
When I thought about it, I was spelling with an E, not an A.
No, Evelyn.
Yeah, I forgot about her.
Exactly. Yeah. See, that's an honorable mention.
Yeah.
Because Evelyn was... I mean, I didn't play the game, but...
Evelyn, maybe?
Evelyn.
Was Evelyn.
Evelyn,
she's
whatever.
French.
Whatever. Okay, the black chick in New Orleans, okay?
It was a good story. It really was. Some of it could have been better, but I understand it being for Vita. Yeah, you can only get what you get.
I didn't play it. I got it on my PC. I got it. I need to play it.
I did. It was pretty good. It's worth your time.
But Alawale, I loved Alawale. Alawale was great. And then Shay, I didn't get to play Rogue.
Yeah, you need to play Rogue.
I have Rogue on my PC.
We will play Rogue. We're playing Rogue, people. He doesn't get a choice about this. I know it's his channel, but not this time. Fuck that. No choice. Playing Rogue. It's going to bring you back. You're going to be like...
After Dream Daddy and after Life is Strange.
Okay. We can do it.
Because we can't do a whole lot.
The fans will be waiting. And I've been playing with Scotch Tape this whole time.
It's fine. And then, fuck Arno. Fuck Arno. Fuck that whole story. Fuck that game. No, fuck that game. He's going to stick up for it.
You've already made a rant about it.
Fuck Arno. Fuck Arno. Fuck Unity. Fuck that game. Fuck it. Fuck it in the ass. Okay. Fuck it in the tight little boy pussy that it is. Fuck that game.
Arno is a character. I like him.
The best character in the game died.
Yeah. But... it is more like a love story, and I understand the point of why they did it, because, you know, Paris and stuff like that. But it didn't make it feel like an Assassin's Creed whatsoever, and the multiplayer fucked it up.
His nickname explains the entire game. It's a piss pot.
I forgot about that.
Well, everybody, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed. If you do, leave a like, subscribe, and all that fun stuff. Let us know if you want to see another top 5 video or top 5, you know, horror movies, top 5 anything. I'll give my opinion because I like fucking doing that, apparently.
Don't we all?
Boo-doo, boo, boo-doo, boo. Bye. With our backs to the wall, the darkness will fall. We never quite thought we could lose it all. Ready, aim, fire. Ready, aim, fire. An empire's falling just one day. You'll close your eyes and the glory fades. Ready, aim, fire. Ready, aim, fire. Distance bubbling up and festering. Hey, Mr. Motion, make me a potion. Shake it all up with your mystery. How come I never seen your face round here? I know every single face round here. A man on a mission, changing the vision. I was never welcome here. We don't have a choice. With our backs to the wall, the darkness will fall. We never quite thought we could lose it all. Ready, aim, fire. Ready, aim, fire. An empire's falling just one day. You close your eyes and the glory fades. Ready, aim, fire. Ready, aim, fire away. Ready, aim, fire. Ready, aim, fire away. Checking the casing, shaking and pacing. Tunnels light, blood in the riding, stuck in the fighting. Look through the rifle sight. How come I never seen your face round here? I know every single face round here. Hearing the heckle, holding the shackle. I was never welcome here. We don't have the choice to stay. We'd rather. With our back.